Greetings, owners of fine luxury cardboard rectangles. We are here today to talk about some of the upcoming changes, including Wizards full reprint policy change for 2021. Basically, the news we're going to be focusing on is arena news, all right? So there's a number of different bullet points we're going to go over from the State of the Arena article that Wizards has recently posted. Now, the first item of note, and this is something people are going to be happy about, is that Macs are finally getting arena access and not through some like wonky setup where you're like, if you have Steam and you use this software and do whatever, you can build your own workaround. Just legitimately being able to play Arena. And it's not a shabby time to be able to get into Arena if you're somebody who hasn't been able to, because we're coming up on a rotation. And we'll talk about that more as well. It's one of the point lists, but I imagine that based on the title of the video and the whole like problem with 2021 and the policy they're enacting is probably the most interesting thing for you, right? You see the title, you're like, okay, what's that about? So here's the deal. When it comes to Arena, there is a unique problem. I mean, there's a couple of different ones, but the unique problem that we're going to look at in this case is the nature of collecting cards on Arena. When you get cards on Arena, they're permanently a part of your collection. You have no ability to dust them like you can in other games, which essentially allows you to take a bunch of your cards and trade them in towards a new card. You can't do anything of that nature. Once you have a card, it's yours forever. Nothing's going to take it away. Even if they ban the card, they don't remove it from your account. But with physical Magic cards, you own X number of copies, right? You can go and do whatever you want with these copies. It's a non-issue. MTGO is somewhat similar because you can trade around extra copies you have of cards. It does have a secondary market, so you can get rid of things. But Arena doesn't allow you to get rid of anything. And that brings us to our current problem, where in 2021, there are multiple cards, six different rares, that are being reprinted in 2021 that already exist in other sets on Arena and are identical in every way except for the set that they're printed in. So by that, I mean they have the exact same, obviously, the card's abilities never change, right? That doesn't really change. But also the exact same artwork. So you end up with a scenario where if you have been somebody who's been loyally either playing Arena enough to like build a lot up with free to play for, like on this channel, I actually did videos talking about how you can use drafts to build out entire play sets of the rares from each set. And I myself did that with a number of sets, most specifically 2021 and Throne of Eldraine. They're the relic, not 2021, that would be amazing if I was able to already collect a set of something that's not already out. Okay, so I got a complete set of four of every rare from 2020 and four of every rare from Throne of Eldraine. Now, 2021 is bringing back the temples again that I've already collected in 2020. Same artwork, same name, same ability. Literally only difference on the card is instead of having M20, it'll say M21. So that's five temple lands. Plus, they are also including Fabled Passage in 2021. So that adds up to six cards in total, but you want four of each. If you've collected four of each like I already have, that's 24 potential rares that you would get from booster packs that would just be like, okay, thanks for playing. Here you go. You have an exact copy of four of these already, and there's no way to ever use more than four, and it doesn't even have different artwork. So there's literally no benefit for you. So Wizards has devised something called their full reprint policy. To be considered a full reprint, it's required, obviously, to have the same name and ability, but also the same artwork. So, with certain cards that exist on Arena right now, like Opt, for example, there are multiple art variations. So if it's a different art variation, that's not a full reprint. So if it's not a full reprint, things function as normal. But these cards that we're dealing with are considered full reprints. So that means we have six rares that count as full reprints. How Wizards is handling it is very, very similar to the way that they are handling cards that have been banned. So how it works is when you open up booster packs, and this doesn't count for drafts, that's a side case we'll go over in a moment, but when you open booster packs on Arena, if you already have four of a reprint, if you already have four copies of it, that will basically move it to the same priority as a banned card, which means you will open it dead last. According to Wizards, the way they posted it on the website, if you open a pack and you would get the land, instead, if you already have four of the full arts, they'll move it to the back and just give you a different rare or mythic from the set. So as long as you haven't collected four of every rare and every mythic other than the lands, you won't get stuck with these lands. Now that doesn't apply to drafts. If you enter into a draft or a sealed event, then you have a normal chance of cracking the lands just like any other rare. They don't change. There's no way to use this to kind of game the drafting system. So for obvious reasons, when it comes to drafts, this full reprint policy will not apply. Now, the only part I'm a little bit confused about is the mythic aspect of it, because as far as I understood, it was like, basically, if you were going to open a rare, then it could shift to one of these other cards. Like, for example, when Agent of Treachery got banned, I thought that if you had all the rares but Agent of Treachery, you would get an Agent of Treachery. But they're making it sound like if you have all the rares and all the mythic rares, then you would get Agent of Treachery. So I'm hoping that this does include mythics as well, but I'm not 100% sure if that is accurate, because sometimes things that are posted by Wizards contradict each other. The information's not clear, but either way, the good news is that we're all not going to get hosed for getting more temples and whatever. And they are programming in a way where, let's say, for example, you had two of each of the temples from 2020. Well, once you get two from 2021, that's your playset of four. It will count the different copies across different printings, or I guess electronic printings. It'll go along your whole collection, and as long as they're functional, complete, full reprints, then you will indeed have that, the luxury of having it moved to the end and not having to worry about it. So that's good, because I'll be real, honestly, with this setup, I was wondering exactly what the right approach to collecting 2021 was. I don't want to get stuck with a bunch of lands. So I might actually avoid drafting this set and just build the set instead through purchasing packs directly, which isn't ideal because it does leave you you're not going to get as many gems because you can get the gems from the drafts, but it does protect you from getting rares that you don't want. So you may get less gems, but it feels like it's a better way to build your collection with 2021. So on top of that information, they've also released information about how Jumpstart is going to function with Arena. We're going to get more specific details, but essentially Jumpstart will be done in the sealed way where you will get two theme packs that will be put together into a deck for you. So you don't get to pick anything like that. It'll just be two random themes mashed together, which I like. I'm looking forward to it. Jumpstart has 500 cards? It's bringing hundreds and hundreds of new cards to Arena. And on that note, there are going to be 20 cards from Jumpstart that are swapped out. Now, there are a number of reasons for this. There's two that feel like the main reason. One is complexity. And I don't mean complexity for the player. I mean complexity for the coders. The people who have to program Arena. I think that some of the cards, they just can't get functional from what I read somewhere. It looks like they're just not able to make certain cards work. So there's the one card that basically says your creature fights your opponent's creature. And then for the rest of the turn, if the creature you fought hits the graveyard, you gain 3 life. So they're swapping that out for a spell that just says target creature fights another creature. So in some cases, it's just like an analog, something that's pretty much a parallel to the card that's being swapped in because it's too difficult to program it in. And in other cases, it's very, very clearly a power level issue where they're going, you know what, we're not putting this in. Because they're not putting in Chain Lightning, and they're not putting in Lightning Bolt as well. You might be able to argue that Chain Lightning, oh, maybe Chain Lightning is too complex to reprint because there is the whole, back and forth aspect of it. If you don't know how Chain Lightning works, basically, I can target you or one of your creatures, but then you have the ability to pay 2 red mana and create a copy of the spell hitting a target of your choice. So you can go back and forth. So you might look at that and go, no, they cut that for complexity, but they also cut lightning bolt. And there's nothing complex about lightning bolt. It's literally the exact same thing as a shock, just change the damage value to 3. So for those, they're both being replaced by lightning strikes, which instead of letting you get 3 damage for 1 mana, let you get 3 damage for 2 mana. So I think what they're doing is probably what we're going to see going forwards when it comes to products that have a bunch of reprints when it comes to Arena, is there's going to be certain cards like Path to Exile and other cards that they're not going to want to put into Historic because they're going to be so powerful that they will invalidate so many cards. Like Path to Exile is such efficient creature destruction that just letting you slam that into Historic basically cuts off a whole bunch of cards that they could feed into Historic first. And I am personally all for a slow drip of new cards into Historic. Like, do it in big batches like this. Yes, add in hundreds of cards, but don't just put in the absolute best cards right away. Let some of the underdog cards that are good, but not good enough when you have everything shine. You know what I mean? It'll lead to some more interesting game states that we haven't seen, and cards that didn't get love actually mattering, which is a nice thing to see. I like when that happens. So Jumpstart will be coming in July. We'll talk more about that when we have more information, but mid-July is when Jumpstart jumps into Arena. The next point I have on my list is Brawler's Guild Hall. Originally, Wizards had Brawl just happening on Wednesdays. They were afraid that too many people would abandon playing regular Standard for Brawl. So they had Brawl set to Wednesdays, and then to kind of come somewhere in between, they also created the Brawler's Guild Hall, where you could play Brawl as much as you wanted, but you had to pay each month to do so. So I guess the idea was they were going to force you to either spend money buying gems or make you play enough Standard games to hit your goals to get the gold, so that either way you were engaged. You know what I mean? Like, that's the kind of scenario that I took that as. That bing totally threw off my train of thought. So originally they were Wednesday only for Brawl, or you have to pay for it. Then they wanted to be cool during the whole situation we've had with the last number of months where everyone's stuck in their homes. So they said, you know what? We're going to make the Guild Hall free. And they did. And the end result they found was that people were playing Brawl not as much as they expected. And it didn't affect their sweet little baby Standard that they were rocking in their arms. So they've decided going forwards that Brawl will just be free and available all the time for Standard Brawl. Historic Brawl is still going to be spread out here or there. They're not planning to do the same thing right away with it. But, I mean, we could get to that point. Who knows? Either way, that's a good step forward. Seeing something where they're no longer charging for it and providing it for free is that's a great piece of news. Now, I mentioned earlier in the video rotation, we are getting close to rotation time. When the next set comes out, and by that I don't mean Core 2021, which releases in a couple days. I mean Zendikar Rising. When Zendikar Rising releases, that is when Core 2020, as well as both Ravnica sets and War of the Spark, all rotate out. If you don't know what that means, rotation just means you can't use it in Standard anymore. They'll still be usable in Historic, and when it comes to Paper Magic, all the older formats, but they will no longer be able to be used in Standard. So they're basically going to have, from this point forwards, they're going to stop running events that use the sets that are going to rotate in like a month and a half, 2 months, whatever it is, 3 months. Either way, I like this as well. They're stopping handing out cards at this point going, you know what, we're gonna get rid of the events that play with these, and we're also going to stop giving individual card rewards from these sets. So going forwards, we're only going to get stuff from Throne of Eldraine, Theros, Ikoria, and 2021 as our individual card rewards. They're also going to be doing the new player decks. So whenever you start playing Arena, they give you a set of 10 decks that you can use, one of each two-color combination, and the last number of the ones have represented, like, the Guilds of Ravnica, and that makes sense because Ravnica has been around. Ravnica was relevant and prevalent. I don't know what exact theme they're going to go with the 10 decks, but I'm guessing they're still going to stick to 10 two-color combinations. So when a new player logs in and they have no decks whatsoever, they'll get those decks. But if you're new and you're wondering, how does it work? Like, am I just going to lose these decks I've been playing with? Wizards is going to give out a set of 10 new intro decks. However, here's how it works. They're only going to give you what you don't already have. So it'll load the deck lists into your arena game, and it will take from your pre-existing cards and add them into the deck. And anything that doesn't exist that you don't already have, Wizards will just give you a copy of. So you don't, everybody doesn't get a full copy of the deck. We learned this the last time around, but it is nice that they'll make sure that you always have some standard decks available, because I use some of those multicolored decks when I get a play X blue spells or play X green. Like, if it's a color combo I'm not playing, I mean, I got green covered, don't worry about that. But if it's a color combo I'm not playing, like white black, I'll just use the Orzhov deck because I don't care. You know what I mean? I'll just play with it, see how well I can do playing with a wonky little kind of beginner deck. So those are coming back with a new set. And we're going to have another renewal event. And I liked this last year. The renewal event was just like, here's a bunch of bonus stuff. If you're somebody who's stuck around and is playing, when rotation hits, you just get stuff. Like last time they gave us a bunch of extra like random rares and stuff. I like that. I think that's pretty cool. Like, you don't get that in Paper Magic. When rotation hits, you're just out your cards. You know what I mean? So I like that on Arena, there are these little like bonuses and whatever. I like collecting up all the stuff. I'm a collector. I enjoy fleshing out my Arena card collection. I want to get everything, even if I'm not playing with it at the time. So that covers all the news I had on that. I am going to be getting out of here, so let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'm really hoping that noise that I heard was some good news. If it is, we're gonna have a cool experience coming for the channel real soon. So if you like what I'm doing, channel is fan funded. You can totally support me on Patreon if you'd like to do so. Make me a happy boy. I slap my hands together like a happy little circus seal who's been given a fish when it happens. So if you want to make me slap it and smile. Oh, wait a minute. All right, you know what? Never mind. I'm out of here.